Hi everyone, a very good evening to all of you. I am Gulab Sah, your mentor, and I welcome you once again to another special session whereby today we are going to talk about certain developmental and regulatory policies that has been released by the Monetary Policy Committee along with the Monetary Policy Statement. So since we have read and talked about the rationale behind the reasons, the rationale why the Monetary Policy Committee came up with such a policy stance and the policy repo rate, now we are going to talk about certain policy measures that are being taken or are proposed to be taken by the Monetary Policy Committee and RBI. So RBI kya kya policy aise hai, specifically in the domain of payment and settlement system, regulation and supervision lana cha raha hai so that it can help in boosting the financial sector of the economy. So without any delay, let's get started. Thoda sa factual hai, but yes, it is important from your examination point of view. So before starting, if you have still not downloaded our app, please go to the Google Play Store. Wahan pe anujindal.in likhiye and download this app. This app is surely going to leverage your performance in the examination. Daily quizzes ho gaye, topper strategies ho gaye, ya phir past year papers, uske analysis, plus free videos and quizzes, everything is available on the app. So make the utmost use of this app in order to leverage your performance. So let's get started. As I have already mentioned, we'll be talking about the statement on developmental and regulatory policy of the month September 2022. First and foremost, isme kya kya cheeze included hai aapke baar mein? Two very important topics are included. The first, it talks about certain policies related to regulation and supervision. Jiske andar there are three specific policies. The first talks about a discussion paper on expected loss-based approach for loan loss provisioning by bank. Kya hota hai? We'll discuss in a short while. Second, discussion paper on securitization of stressed assets. The stressed assets kya hote hain? NPA kya hota hai? Uske baare mein samjhenge. And third is internet banking facility for customers of regional rural banks. Theek hai? Second major topic or heading is payment and settlement system. Aur iske andar we are going to talk about regulating the offline payment aggregators. So jo hamare offline payment regulators aggregators hain, unko regulate karne ki baat ki jayegi is very topic mein. So let's get started to understand one by one what does it means by expected loss based approach for loss provisioning by banks. Sabse simple cheez ye dekho, whenever, what is an asset for a bank? So banks ki jo balance sheet hoti hai, the balance sheet of banks are very different from that of companies. Companies ke case mein, their assets are the machineries, the plant and machineries, the equipments, the buildings, the type of raw materials, work in progress that they are having, that are known as the asset for the companies. However, in the case of banks, it is the opposite. It is the loans that it has provided to the creditors. Such loans will comprise the asset base or the asset class of the banking sector. Unke liye loans kya hongi, liabilities kya hongi, deposits. The public which are depositing money into these banks will be the liability for a bank. Their assets will be the loan which they have provided. Now loan ke saath ek problem hai. What is the problem with the loan? The problem with loan is that kai bar aisa hota hai that creditors default in making the payment. So when this happens, then these banks suffer a lot of losses, right? तो कई बार क्या होता है, जब आपने अगर कंपनी की बैलेंस शीट पढ़ी होगी, वहां पे आपको ये प्रोविजन पढ़ाया जाता है दैट इन केस सपोज कोई डेटर है, सपोज यू आर सेलिंग गुड्स, आपकी एक किराने की दुकान है, देयर इज अ रिटेल स्टोर एंड यू आर सेलिंग सर्टेन गुड्स. नाउ एक बंदा है बोरोवर, वो आता है आपसे बाकी भी सामान खरीद रहा है एंड एट द एंड ऑफ द मंथ ही मेक्स द पेमेंट. सपोज ऐसा करो कि सपोज उसने पेमेंट ही नहीं की और कोई चांस है भी नहीं कि वो पेमेंट करे उस महीने, इधर ही इज आउट ऑफ द टाउन और ही हैज फ्लू अवे. इन दैट केस वो जो एसेट है, वो जो पैसे जो आपको आने थे, वो आपके लिए लॉस हो जाएगा, राइट? तो ऐसे सिचुएशन ना हो इसके लिए कंपनीज, बैंक्स एंड फाइनेंशियल इंस्टीट्यूशन फॉलो ए कंसेप्ट कॉल्ड प्रूडेंसी। प्रूडेंसी क्या बोलती है या प्रूडेंट क्या अप्रोच क्या बोलती है? प्रूडेंसी सेज दैट यू नीड टू एंटिसिपेट ऑल काइंड ऑफ लॉसेस बट यू शुड नॉट प्रोवाइड फॉर एनी काइंड ऑफ रेवेन्यू। That means, अगर आपको लग रहा है that in future there is going to be some kind of losses, then in that case you need to provide for it. आपको provisions provide करने पड़ेंगे, आपको अभी से उसके लिए एक category prepare करनी पड़ेगी कि अगर ये loss होता है तो मैं हर महीने थोड़ा थोड़ा पैसा डालता जाऊंगा, so that at the end if that loss happens, I have sufficient money to cover that. फॉर एग्जाम्पल डेप्रिसिएशन का केस लेते हैं, व्हेनेवर ए मशीनरी इज परचेज साइमल्टेनियसली डेप्रिसिएशन अकाउंट इज मेंटेन्ड। इसका ये मतलब नहीं हुआ कि अगर आपने मशीनरी खरीदी हर साल यूज करके अगर उसकी वैल्यू कम हो रही है तो आप उसके लिए कुछ पे कर रहे हो। डेप्रिसिएशन इज ए नॉन कैश एक्सपेंस बट यू प्रोवाइड फॉर डेप्रिसिएशन ईच ईयर इन द व्यू दैट वंस द एसेट गेट्स utilize completely, you have enough funds with yourself to provide for that assets. या आप नए assets को खरीद सकते हो या उसको upgrade कर सकते हो, ठीक है? Similar is the provision with prudency which says, अगर लग रहा है कि loss होगा तो provision बनाओ, अभी से थोड़ा थोड़ा allocate करना शुरू करो। However, it also says, अगर लग रहा है that if you are anticipating कि future में revenue आएगा, in that case you need not provide for any kind of provisions. This is applicable only in case of prudency. Now, in case of losses. Now, this is a very important concept. Prudency आपको आपके companies act, कुछ भी financial related transactions है, वहाँ पे it's a very very important concept. And please इसको ध्यान रखिए, specially जो SEBI के लिए prepare कर रहे हैं, this is very important concept. Questions जरूर आते हैं यहाँ से, ठीक है? तो अब तक तो आपको समझ आ गया कि provisioning करनी पड़ती है for anticipated losses. तो अब तक क्या हो रहा था? Currently banks were following a norm whereby once the loss happens, अगर loss होती थी उसके बाद वो provisioning करते थे. But RBI in order to converge with the globally accepted principles, जो globally accepted prudential principles हैं, in order to work in that line, RBI has now proposed to introduce an expected loss based approach. पहले हम क्या follow कर रहे थे? We were currently following the incurred loss approach. Loss हुआ, किसी ने payment नहीं की, then only you were going for this provisioning part. But now you need to calculate, and if you feel like that certain assets of the bank are not going to come back, certain loans that you have provided will not come back, in that case you need to provide provisioning for such assets based on the expected loss based approach. I hope it is very simple and easy to understand. Aapko samajh aa gaya hoga. And for this, a discussion paper will be released by RBI so that it can take on the comments of various stakeholders and market participants so that this approach could be fully developed. I hope aapko ye samajh aa gaya hoga. Now let's move forward and talk about the second policy in the regulation and supervision part, which again says a discussion paper on securitization of stressed assets framework. पहले समझते हैं न्यूज क्या है एंड देन वी विल टॉक अबाउट द कंसेप्ट। नाउ इट सेज दैट करंटली ऑन 2021, सो सितंबर 2021 में आरबीआई हैड इश्यूड अ रिवाइज्ड फ्रेमवर्क फॉर सिक्योरिटाइजेशन ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड एसेट्स। तो जो स्टैंडर्ड एसेट्स थे हमारे पास, नाउ व्हाट आर दी स्टैंडर्ड एसेट्स? दीज आर दोज एसेट्स और दोज लोन्स गिवन बाय द बैंक्स टू द बोरोवर्स, एंड अगेंस्ट दीज लोन्स यू डू नॉट फील लाइक देयर इज गोइंग टू बी एनी काइंड ऑफ लॉसेस। यू फील दीज एसेट्स will be safe and you will be getting back the money. So these assets are known as standard assets. So apart from any kind of business loss, जो normal banking, कुछ भी एक normal market risk होता है, which is applicable to all, right? जिसको आप diversify नहीं कर सकते. Apart from that loss, there is not going to be any other kind of losses. That is known as standard asset. So these are your good asset, good loans that you have provided. तो 2021 में आरबीआई ने फिर भी एक प्रोविजनिंग नॉर्म निकाला था, फ्रेमवर्क फॉर सिक्योरिटाइजेशन ऑफ द standard assets. Now, in line of that, RBI has now decided to introduce a framework for securitization of stressed assets. Ab stressed assets kya hote hain? So these stressed assets are basically the NPAs, the non-performing assets. Ya fir aise assets which are written off from your balance sheet, but still you have incurred that loss. So any kind of loss assets or the NPAs are considered to be a stress for the company, for the banks, and therefore they are designated as stressed assets. So inke liye ab securitization lai jayegi. Now what is securitization? Securitization do bar aa gaya, hota kya hai? So securitization is very simple. Securitization ka matlab hota hai ki aap whatever the loan is there, suppose bahut sare a bank is providing n number of loans to the consumers, to the borrowers, to the investors, to the companies. Now what, in case of securitization, these loans are going to be categorized, all kinds of homogeneous loans consisting of equal risk or similar risk. Jitne bhi similar risk ke loans honge, suppose there is one category of asset that is having a risk of around 30%, another category 50%, another 80%. So you are going to categorize these loans or assets into separate homogeneous category, and then you will compile these assets and sell them to any other financial institution or company, so that the stress that you are having on your balance sheet, the NPEs that you are having on your balance sheet, gets chucked down, and those companies who are purchasing these stressed homogeneous assets, these assets will be dealing with the recovery of the payment. So banks kya karti hain in case of, so this is the concept that I'm talking about, is of asset reconstruction companies. So these are financial institution companies, and what they do is they come to the banks and at a mutually agreed price. Suppose koi bhi ek price hai that the bank and the ARC decides, and at this mutually agreed price, the banks sell off all of their NPAs and stressed assets to these ARCs. Ab banks ko logon ke peeche nahi padna padega ki aapne loan liya tha, aap interest pay nahi kar rahe, aap principal payment nahi kar rahe. Now all the hectic, all the time and effort that was required by the bank will be reduced, since it has sold all of these assets to the ARCs, the financial institution companies that are dealing with bad loans, yeah, bad assets. And now the banking, jo banking balance sheet hai, that will be more clean, and these ARCs are now going to talk and use several other measures. Chahe wo interest rate kam kar sakte hain, ya fir they can make it more lucrative, ya fir there is a concept called carrot, right? Carrot and stick approach ko use karke us paise ko nikal sakte hain in borrower se. So it is entirely the work of ARC now to get that money from the borrowers. This is known as securitization, whereby you securitize or you list similar category assets or loans into similar piles, and then you sell them off in order to make your balance sheet clean. I hope it is very simple. Now the introduction of this framework for securitization of stressed assets is based on the recommendation of the task force on development of secondary market for corporate loans. So ek task force form hua tha 2019 mein by RBI, and this task force was on the development of the secondary market for corporate loans. So secondary market ko use karke corporate loans lene ki baat chal rahi thi, and these recommendations are of this task force only, in order to have a framework for securitization of stress assets. Now this framework is going to act as an alternative mechanism to the currently asset reconstruction companies. So we have this asset reconstruction companies that deals with the bad loans or the bad assets. Now apart from that, we are going to have a framework for securitization of stressed assets. Now kis act ke andar aata hai, are they legal, are they statutory? Yes, these are legal and they come under the SARFAESI Act. Now this act is very 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 important. Iska full form exam mein aapke RBI SEBI ke exam mein pucha gaya hai. You should remember it and you should understand the intent behind this act. Theek hai, asset reconstruction companies or SARFAESI Act bahut hi important hai. इसको डिटेल में हमारे कोर्स में कराया जाएगा, राइट, इन द लाइफ फाइनेंस, इन द लाइफ फाइनेंस कोर्सेज, ठीक है. सो व्हाट इज द फुल फॉर्म ऑफ सारफेसी? सारफेसी स्टैंड्स फॉर सिक्योरिटाइजेशन एंड रिकंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ फाइनेंशियल एसेट्स एंड एनफोर्समेंट ऑफ सिक्योरिटी इंटरेस्ट. एंड दिस एक्ट वॉज पास इन द ईयर 2022. अब इसके लिए डिस्कशन पेपर को लाया जाएगा इन ऑर्डर टू गेट कॉमेंट्स फ्रॉम डिफरेंट स्टेक होल्डर्स. दिस आर द मीनिंग्स ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड एसेट्स क्या होते हैं, स्ट्रेस्ड एसेट्स क्या होते हैं, वी हैव ऑलरेडी टॉक्ड अबाउट इट. आपको PDF प्रोवाइड किया जाएगा सो दैट यू कैन रीड एंड देन रिटेन फॉर अ लॉन्गर पीरियड ऑफ टाइम. Now, what are NPAs? NPAs की हम बहुत बात करते हैं. Just very short, we are going to discuss or talk about it. What are NPAs? So, whatever loan you have provided, if the interest or the principal amount, if the bank is not receiving for up to 90 days, अगर 3 महीने तक if you are not getting the interest payment, then such loans will be known as NPA. For example, suppose you go to a bank, SBI bank, and you take a loan of rupees 1 lakh and upon that you need to pay 10,000 rupees interest per month. For example, interest plus principal, 10,000 aapko har mahine dene. You paid for the first month, second month because you had certain liquidity crunch, you could not make the payment. ठीक है, बैंक ने कॉल किया, उन्होंने बोला विल बी चार्जिंग मोर मनी, मोर इंटरेस्ट सिंस यू हैव डिफॉल्टेड ऑन योर EMI पेमेंट. For the second month again, you are unable to make the payment, your EMI payment, the bank again warns you. Now this is worrisome for the banks. उसको अब लगने लगेगा कि यार ये पैसे नहीं दे रहा है, and there are chances that this loan account, this asset of mine is going to be NPA. अगर ऐसा कुछ होता है तो इसको हम बोलते हैं स्पेशल मेंशन अकाउंट. तो यहाँ पे एक वर्ड मेंशन है, स्पेशल मेंशन अकाउंट, आई होप यू कैन सी इट. इसका यही मतलब है, व्हेन द बैंक फील्स दैट देयर आर सिम्टम्स दैट दीस एसेट्स और दीस लोन्स दैट आई हैव प्रोवाइडेड विल टर्न इनटू अ बैड एसेट और अ बैड क्वालिटी एसेट, सच एसेट्स आर नोन एज स्पेशल मेंशन अकाउंट. आई होप दिस इज नाउ क्लियर टू यू. So moving back to the example that we were talking about, तो आपने second month भी अपना EMI payment नहीं किया. If suppose you are not making your EMI payment for the very third month, अब ये 90 days हो गए. Now the loan that the bank has provided to you, the bank will now categorize this loan as an NPA, non-performing assets, the assets on which the bank is not able to generate any kind of revenue. रेवेन्यू जनरेट नहीं कर पा रही है एंड दीज आर नोन एज नॉन परफॉर्मिंग एसेट्स. नाउ देयर आर सेवरल कैटेगरीज ऑफ एनपीए. एनपीए की 3 कैटेगरी है. एक होता है सब स्टैंडर्ड एसेट्स. स्टैंडर्ड एसेट्स एज वी हैव डिस्कस्ड, दीज आर गुड एसेट्स. नाउ वी हैव सब स्टैंडर्ड एसेट्स. सो इफ यू आर नॉट मेकिंग द पेमेंट, द रीपेमेंट, इफ द बैंक इज नॉट रिसीविंग द इंटरेस्ट और द प्रिंसिपल पेमेंट फॉर अप टू 12 months, then that these assets will be known as substandard. And in case of doubtful assets, the borrower is not returning the payment or these NPAs have aged for more than 12 months. अब इसमें भी बहुत सारे category हैं, detail में आप पढ़ लेना. And third is the lost assets. What are lost assets? So when the banks or its auditors, जब भी banks की audit होती है, if they have concluded that that these assets are lost, यहाँ से कोई भी recovery नहीं हो सकती, still you have not written off from your balance sheet. आप कैसे written off करोगे? If you have certain provision. So if you are not able to write off from your balance sheet, such losses are known as lost assets. Simple. I hope this is clear to you. Now moving forward to SARFAESI Act and asset reconstruction companies, I have already discussed with you. Just go through the slides, very simple and easy to understand. Now the next policy that has been talked about in the monetary policy statement. So it talks about internet banking facility for customers of regional rural banks. अब देखो, रीजनल रूरल बैंक्स, सिंस दे आर स्पेसिफिकली इन द रूरल एरियाज एंड सर्टन वेरी हार्ड और स्ट्रिंजेंट रूल्स एंड रेगुलेशंस वेर एप्लीकेबल ऑन दीज रूरल रीजनल रूरल बैंक्स इन ऑर्डर टू प्रोवाइड एनी काइंड ऑफ इंटरनेट बैंकिंग फैसिलिटी, अगर ये ऑनलाइन बैंकिंग फैसिलिटी प्रोवाइड कर रहे थे देन दे वर रिक्वायर्ड टू फर्स्ट टेक द प्रायर अप्रूवल ऑफ आरबीआई एंड दे वर ऑल्सो सब्जेक्ट टू एन एन नंबर ऑफ फाइनेंशियल एंड नॉन फाइनेंशियल क्राइटेरिया. बट सिंस फाइनेंशियल इंक्लूजन की बात चलती है एंड वी वॉन्ट इंडिया टू बी अ फाइनेंशियली इंक्लूडेड कंट्री एंड आर स्कोर ऑन द फाइनेंशियल इंक्लूजन इंडेक्स टू बी टूवर्ड्स 100 इन दैट सिनेरियो इन दीज डेवलपमेंट आरबीआई इन ऑर्डर टू प्रमोट एंड स्प्रेड द डिजिटल बैंकिंग हैज नाउ रिमूव्ड और लोअर डाउन द क्राइटेरिया फॉर आर आर बीज टू प्रोवाइड इंटरनेट बैंकिंग फैसिलिटी. तो इनके लिए गाइडलाइंस फिर से इशू किए जाएंगे एंड दिस गाइडलाइंस विल बी लेस स्ट्रिंजेंट एज कंपेयर टू द प्रीवियस वन. वेरी सिंपल, जस्ट टू प्रमोट डिजिटल बैंकिंग रेगुलेशंस विल बी लेस स्ट्रिंजेंट फॉर रीजनल रूरल बैंक्स. नाउ द नेक्स्ट क्राइटेरिया और कैटेगरी इज पेमेंट एंड सेटलमेंट सिस्टम. इसके अंदर क्या आया है, what is the policy that RBI has been talking about, it is regulating the offline payment aggregators. Now see, payment aggregators could be online or offline and these online payment aggregators could be either a third party payment aggregator that helps the merchants in order to get money or in order to transfer money from the customer टू दी मर्चेंट्स अकाउंट. सो पेमेंट एग्रीगेटर का काम ही यही होता है, इट प्रोवाइड्स यू विद द फैसिलिटी ऑफ ट्रांसफरिंग द कस्टमर्स मनी टू द मर्चेंट्स अकाउंट. जब भी आप कभी भी शॉपिंग करते हो, अगर मैं आपको बताऊं ऑफलाइन शॉपिंग की बात करें, अगर आप शॉपिंग करने जाते हैं इन दैट केस यू स्वाइप योर कार्ड राइट. नाउ दीज मशीन कुड either be of an online operator or an offline operator. Online operators such as Visa, MasterCard, NPCI ke ho sakte hain, bill desk ho sakte hain, right? Now payment aggregators can also be your payment gateways. So payment gateways ka kya kaam hai? They provide you with the technology. Aapko ek website, ek platform provide karte hain. So they provide you with the technology and the platform to transfer the funds. However, the management of the funds, the money which is managed from the customer to the merchant account is done by the payment aggregator. तो क्या कह रहा है इसमें, इसमें यही बताया है that the payment aggregators which can be banks as well as non-banks and third party payment aggregators as well were brought into the RBI's regulation in March 2020. ठीक है, and these current regulations are applicable only to payment aggregators that are processing online. बट सिंस ऑफलाइन किराना स्टोर्स पे भी बहुत ज़्यादा यूज हो रहे हैं आजकल, सो इट इज़ इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर फ्रॉम द पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू ऑफ द कस्टमर्स इन ऑर्डर टू सेव गार्ड देयर मनी दैट दीज ऑफलाइन पेमेंट एग्रीगेटर्स आर ऑल्सो रेगुलेटेड. सो सिंस ऑफलाइन पेमेंट एग्रीगेटर्स वे आर नॉट रेगुलेटेड एंड सिंस दे हैंडल proximity of face-to-face transactions and play a significant role in the spread of digital payments. Keeping in view of that, now the offline payment aggregators will also come under the purview of the regulations of RBI. Very simple. इसके पीछे मोटिव क्या है? एक तो आप ऑफलाइन पेमेंट रेगुलेटर को भी पेमेंट एग्रीगेटर को रेगुलेट कर सकते हो एंड सेकेंडली यू कैन क्रिएट अ काइंड ऑफ सिनर्जी इन रेगुलेशन. So it will be a uniform based regulation for both the online and the offline aggregators. Apart from that, it will be very easier for RBI now to collect data on these from these payment aggregators. So this was in the news, the monetary policy statement that talks about the development and the regulatory policies. I hope aapko samajh aa gaya hoga. Simple, easy, interesting. Certain concepts were very, very important. उनको प्लीज याद रखो, एग्जाम पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू से बहुत ही इंपॉर्टेंट है. नाउ दीज आर सर्टन ऑफलाइन पेमेंट एग्रीगेटर्स फॉर ऑल ऑफ यू जिनको थोड़ा सा कंफ्यूजन था कि ऑफलाइन कौन से होते हैं. सो दीज आर द ऑफलाइन पेमेंट एग्रीगेटर्स सच एज द पाइन लैब्स, हिताची का है, देन वी हैव एम स्वाइप, या आपने देखा भी होगा, देन वी हैव इजी टैप, वर्ल्ड लाइन एंड फाइनली FSS पावरिंग पेमेंट्स. ठीक है, समझ आ गया. नाउ टू क्वेश्चंस फॉर यू बेस्ड ऑन व्हाट एवर वी हैव डिस्कस्ड, प्लीज राइट इट डाउन इन द कमेंट सेक्शन द आंसर्स टू दिस क्वेश्चन. द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन सेज वी नीड टू आइडेंटिफाई द इनकरेक्ट स्टेटमेंट्स. द फर्स्ट स्टेटमेंट, इन 2021 आरबीआई हैड इशूड रिवाइज्ड फ्रेमवर्क फॉर सिक्योरिटाइजेशन ऑफ सब स्टैंडर्ड एसेट्स, अगर आपने ध्यान से सुना होगा, इट इज वेरी इजी टू आंसर. Second, in the recent September 2022 meet of MPC, it has been decided to introduce a framework for securitization of stressed asset. The third statement says this is based on the recommendation of the task force on development of money market for corporate loans. And finally, the fourth statement says this will provide an alternative mechanism for securitization of NPAs in addition to the existing ARC. You need to identify the incorrect statements. So, jab bhi aise questions aaye, first and foremost, you need to know whether you need to identify the correct or the incorrect statements. Kai bar kya hota hai? You are able to identify the statements, but because of this silly mistake, you make the mistake in the exam. So, isko please dhyan mein rakho. Now moving forward to the next question, which says in the recent September 2022 meet of the Monetary Policy Committee, the MPC has proposed banks to converge with the globally accepted prudential norms by introducing dash 4 provisioning on their लोन एसेट्स. अगर लोन एसेट्स को प्रोविजन करना है तो अब हमें किस अप्रोच को फॉलो करना है? दीज आर दी ऑप्शंस फॉर यू. वेरी सिंपल, अगेन write it down in the comment section the correct answer to this. So this was all for today that I wanted to discuss with you. The answers has already been shared in this PDF, and the PDF will be available to you on the Telegram group. I hope you like the session. In case of any doubt, please feel free to reach out to us in the comment section or on the discussion forum, and keep learning. Till then, take care and bye bye.